been operating under deception from the very start. Didn't he deceive Adam and Eve into God? We've been operating under deception from the very start. After he'd been let loose for 1,000 years, after being bound up for 1,000 years, let loose, what did he go out to do? Go right out and deceive all the nations. Go ahead, read them.
Gog and Magog, gathering them together to battle.
Now, he done somehow convinced them that they need to go up and fight against God. You think this ain't a powerful being here? No, no. Ain't nothing been taught but the word of God for 1,000 years. Because he's been taken completely out of commission. And if there's a false prophet that want to rise up, the book said that his own family going to kill him. So, you know, you ain't basically, only thing you got being taught is the true word of God for 1,000 years. Soon as he let loose for a little season, he managed to go out to see the nation and convince them to come up and fight against God. Go ahead, read them.
The number of whom is as the sand of the sea.
Go ahead, read.
And they went up on the breadth of the earth and compassed the camp of the saints about.
Go ahead.
And the beloved city. And fire came down from God out of heaven and devoured them.
Go ahead.
And the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone.
Now he said the devil that deceived them, he was cast into the lake of fire. And until this time, you got to deal with him. Make no mistake about it. You know, he's going to be taken out of commission for 1,000 years. But until this time, man got to deal with him. You know, if you be those that be so blessed to be changed when the Lord returns, then you're okay. You're on safe ground. You can't mess up and do nothing wrong. But if you one of those that's still going to be mortal man during this 1,000 years, then you're going to have to deal with him. Go ahead and read on.
Where the beasts and the false prophets are.
Go ahead.
And shall be tormented day and night forever and ever.
So now you finally have the last of the evil spirit. Until that time, you're going to have to deal with it. Let's go and read one other thing here. Let's go to Revelation 21 and pick it up at verse 6. Revelation 21 and verse 6. Okay, go ahead and read.
And he said unto me, it is done.
Mm-hmm.
I am Alpha and Omega.
Go ahead.
The beginning and the end.
Uh-huh.
I will give unto him that is a thirst of the fountain of water of life freely.
Now, you know, the Father's here at this time. You understand what I'm saying? But he's going to let you know here what happened to the sorcerers. Go ahead and read on.
He that overcometh shall inherit all things.
Uh-huh.
And I will be his God.
Go ahead.
And he shall be my son.
Go ahead.
But the fearful.
He said, but the fearful. Go ahead and read.
And unbelieving.
Yes.
And the abominable.
Go ahead.
And the murderer.
Go ahead.
And the whoremonger.
Yes.
And sorcerers.
And the sorcerers. Go ahead and read.
And the idolaters.
And the idolaters. Go ahead.
And all liars.
Uh-huh.
Shall have their part in the lake which burned with fire and brimstone.
Finally, you're done with the sorcerers. So now you have, you know, the evil spirits. You know who they are. You understand how they operate. So you know you need to beware of their devices. Thank you, and I hope you learned something this lesson.